Welcome back to today's class, children. In the last class, we have completed the lesson Separation of Substances. Today, let us move on to the next lesson. Children, you might have observed a small baby becoming an infant and then growing into a child. Isn't it? A seed, when you sow it in the soil, it is growing into a sapling, that is baby plant, and then growing into a tree. Yes, the days are becoming as nights. Season is changing. Now this is winter, rainy and summer. We have three seasons. Now this is monsoon, that is rainy season. Rainy season is becoming as, first you will have summer and then comes the rainy and then comes the winter. Okay, so what are all these, children? Yes, these are all the changes, right? So, which is taking place in our nature. So, our next lesson is changes around us. What is a change? Let us know. Change is a phenomenon. It is a process in which an object becomes different. A phenomenon in which an object becomes different in its shape, color, size, position and its composition. Even its composition changes. Let us take a seed. A seed will be in the soil. It grows as days move on. It grows into a small sapling, that is a baby plant. Then a baby plant will be coming out. It grows into, you all know that, it grows into a root and a shoot, and the shoot comes out and slowly the plant grows and grows and then it becomes as a tree. So there it changes. That is, it changes its shape, color, size, position and even sometimes its composition. So once it becomes a tree, even it starts giving the fruit. So what is a change, children? It is a phenomenon in which an object becomes different in its shape, color, size, position and its composition. Here, in this lesson, we are going to learn mainly about three different types of changes, children. The first one is the slow and fast change. The second one is physical and chemical change. And third one is reversible and irreversible change. So, today's class, we are going to discuss about slow change, fast change, and then about the reversible and irreversible change. What do you mean by slow change? The name itself says that, children, it is a change which takes longer duration of time, means slow. Okay, so slow change is a change which takes longer duration of time. And fast, name says, it happens very quickly. That is, it is a change which takes shorter duration of time. A change which takes longer duration of time is called a slow change. And a change which takes shorter duration of time is called as a fast change. Okay. Slow change examples are change of seasons. So, seasons occurring due to the revolution of the earth around the sun. Okay. So, it takes months. That is why it is a slow change. Growth of a plant. A seed growing into a plant. It takes time. Rusting of iron. Rusting means on an iron, the reddish brown product which is formed, that takes a longer duration. So, all these are the examples of slow change. Now, coming to fast change. What is a fast change? Burning of paper. When you burn a paper, immediately it burns quickly and it changes into ash, right? So, it is an example of a fast change. Lighting of bulb. When you switch on the bulb, it glows. When you switch it off, it becomes off. It does not glow. So, that is also an example of a fast change. Changing milk into cheese. In milk, when you just drop one drop of little squeeze lemon, a drop of lemon juice in the milk, it changes completely into cheese. Okay, children. So, these are all the examples of slow change and fast change. Now, coming to rust. What is rust? Rust is a reddish brown substance formed due to corrosion of iron. Okay. So why it is getting corroded? In Telugu we say it as tuppu pattipoyindi. See, if there is a cycle, children, an old cycle which is left for so many months without using it, then what happens? You can see some brown color coating which is formed on the iron, the cycle, yes, wherever you keep pedaling it and all, yes. So why? Because it is reacting with the iron, reacts with moisture and oxygen. The iron reacts with moisture and oxygen, and because of that, moisture means wet. The wetness will be there in the air, that is called as moisture. So because of the moisture and oxygen present in the air, the rust is formed. Okay, so how can you prevent this rust? We can prevent it by painting, greasing, oiling, etc. That is why you might have observed. Yes, so you will also take your cycle once in a while to do the oiling and greasing to prevent it from getting rusted. Okay, children, so that is nothing but a rust. Now, coming to the second type of change, that is reversible and irreversible change. So what is reversible? Reversible means getting back. Okay, the substance which is produced can get back to its original form. So that type of change is called as reversible change. Irreversible is opposite, that is which we cannot get back into the original form. Okay, and this reversible change is a temporary change, means it remains only for a shorter time and then we can get back the substance. It is a temporary change which can be reversed when the cause of the change is removed. Okay, and it is a permanent, irreversible is a permanent change. When you burn a paper, the paper burns into ash, but we cannot get back the paper from the ash. So that is also an example of a irreversible change. When you get back the substance again, it is called as a reversible change. Example, evaporation. We know water cycle, water gets evaporated, forms into the clouds, and again the water is coming back and into the seas and oceans, into the rivers and lakes, right? So you are getting back the substance. So evaporation is also an example of reversible change. Stretching of rubber band. When you stretch a rubber band and release it, it comes back to its original position. Even spring, when you can play with the spring also, yes, yes. Then switching on or off a light bulb, so it comes back to its original position. So all these are the examples of reversible change. Now coming to irreversible change, getting older, an infant is becoming into an adult, a child, then an adult is changing into an older woman or a man, right? A grandmother or a grandfather. But can the grandfather and grandmother come back into a child? It's not possible, right? So it is irreversible. So getting older is an example of an irreversible change. And changing the milk into curd. Okay, so changing milk into curd. From the curd, we cannot get back the milk again. So it is also an example of irreversible change.